So, how long have you been training before you reach this current stage?
Well, I think I started off when I was around about 16, starting off in an academy setup, and then obviously training then easy four times a week at that time, and then as you progress, the training gets harder and longer. But I mean, the amount of training me and Joe do, it's pretty much every day of the week in preparation for the game on the weekend. But it's particularly difficult in pre-season because of the less games. They tend to ramp up the training load and volume. So Joe will back up their pre-season.
Yeah, really is. I mean, I started when I was 12 in year 7 playing rugby for school, and since then going through the age grades and stuff. But as soon as you get into the academy, it's in, you guys have seen the gym down here, it's in here, starting weights in the morning at 7 o'clock, and then getting over to school for 8 o'clock. It's tough, but then straight after school, then you're back here, you're doing more training, and you're then back again over to school to finish off training the night. That is your day, and you don't get to see a lot. You go training, school training, for a lot of sixth form stuff. Definitely pre-season is a very long time.
How have you found the whole trying to maintain the work-life balance with everything else going on in your schedule?
I suppose it has been difficult because you're trying to fit so much things in. I mean, obviously training is important and personal development, but you've got to also enjoy yourself alongside that. And it is difficult to fit it all in. But I mean, Joe will back me up here. No, I think obviously, being a professional sportsman, we have to put out training and, like I said again, personal development first before fun. But when we do get the chance to have fun, then we have fun.
Because I study in uni as well, I think it's important to have something almost completely opposite to what you do. So, if you're not training, you can't just be at home, sat there playing PlayStation. You've got to be doing something, always, otherwise you're going to burn out. Constantly thinking about rugby, constantly doing training, and it's physically tiring as well as mentally tiring. So having that personal development, like Dan said, is important as well as having fun.
So there's like a lot of community projects going on between the team and the locals. What would you say has been the benefit of working with the community, and how has that impacted your own progress?
I think obviously working with community is really important in terms of getting more support for the club and the region, I'd say. But I think for me and Joe as players, I think for our own personal development again, I think getting out there in the community, increasing your social skills with regards to communication, working with others. I mean, Joe backed me up, we've been sent up to schools and different kind of events. I think just working with the different variety of people has improved us as people, I'd say, just in our overall general skills.
Yeah, again, building social skills, building generally your own life skills. So I'm a level one coach now, so going along with Mike, who you guys met earlier, going to schools and helping just teach kids basic drills, just getting them involved in activities and getting them moving and getting them enjoying it. That's what is very rewarding. So.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you.